الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. We begin in the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We praise him and we request praises, blessings and salutations upon Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. To my dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, سلام الله عليكم ورحمته وبركاته. May Allah's peace and blessings and safety be upon you all, and I welcome you all to episode number 6 of our short Dhul Hijjah series together dedicated towards the Hajj and the family and common foundations between them both. For today's episode, brothers and sisters in Islam, I want to zoom into the concept of the Jamarat during Hajj and draw a parallel from this concept and tie it along to the family and, more importantly, a successful, productive, transformative family. We know, brothers and sisters in Islam, that the idea of the Jamarat stems from Ibrahim alayhi salam and him walking into Mina with Ismail alayhi salam, doing everything in his capacity to follow through the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, related to slaughtering Ismail alayhi salam. And as he was making this journey, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as they walked this journey that to us is very short today, but back then was very long, and given what Ibrahim had to do, it was definitely much longer than it should have been. He was remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right, through every flat path, through every hilltop, training himself to put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Saying Allahu Akbar, Allah is greater, Allah is greater. There is no one worthy of worship besides one Allah. I don't worship my desires, I don't worship my fancies, I don't worship my whims. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allah is greater than me, my desire, my son, my whims, my fancy. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Allah is greater, and for him is all praise. He's the owner of all praise, right? So he's training himself. Ibrahim alayhi salam is training himself. And shaitan, no doubt, is watching the circumstance and situation and thinking, what a mighty opposition Ibrahim alayhi salam entails. So shaitan sends reinforcements, right? Because the fancies and whims and desires of man, which shaitan can manipulate via the qareen, right? There's this qareen that always pushes us towards evil, wasn't working. So he sends these shayateen, and these shayateen come to him at three different intervals, at intervals that you and I understand to be the place of the Jamarats today, at these three places. And each devil was assigned to sway Ibrahim alayhi salam off the path of obedience, right? That's what the devil's job is. And the devil can use piety if it helps you miss being righteous and pious, right? Because it's from piety to preserve life. It's from piety to look after your child. It's from piety to give your life up to save your child. It's a righteous thing to do, that you preserve your child's life, even if it means there's a chance of you being harmed. And you can only imagine what kind of ideas these shayateen were presenting to Ibrahim. But no doubt, all of this meant a lack of righteousness and piety, if it meant going against a direct command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ibrahim understood this alayhi salam, and he stoned these jamarat, he stoned these shayateen. So each one of them, he stoned them with 7 pebbles, throwing these pebbles at the shayateen, announcing Allahu Akbar, Allah is greater, Allah is greater, Allah is greater than what you're telling me and what you're whispering to me, and so on and so forth. And he defeated them. Now today we have the concept of the Jamarat, which gives us a chance to mimic and act beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And many people, when I'm on Hajj, I do advise the group of people that are around me to really develop a sense of meaning behind the act. Don't just go and throw stones at a stone wall, right? Before it was a pillar, now it's a wall. But try and bring Ibrahim's situation as close as possible to yours and my situation. You and I, we have sins today, sins that defeat us, right? So if we could ponder over those sins and attach it to a pebble and go to that place and pelt it, because that is a day where shaitan is being humiliated greatly, because shaitan knows why the ummah is doing what they're doing. and he's remembering and made to remember over the course of the days with every stone that is thrown, what he felt when Ibrahim alayhi salam defeated him, right? So if we take a sin, attach it to a pebble with a sincere intention to leave that sin behind in the pit at the Jamarat, and this, inshallah, would be a means of assisting ourselves when we go back home against falling into that sin again. And we throw that sin into that pit saying, Allahu Akbar, Allah is greater. Allah is greater than the desires that push me to follow that sin. Right? So this is an idea. Now I want to take this idea into the family unit. How can the family unit benefit from this? Because brothers and sisters in Islam, whenever we see turbulence in the family, a lot of the times really it's petty and it's shaitan that is fueling fires at the side of the husband, at the side of the wife, at the side of the parents, at the side of the children, making a mountain out of a molehill, creating a circumstance that slowly but surely becomes untenable and unsustainable, but it didn't have to get there. And then we know sometimes it ends in a talaq, a divorce happens, the husband utters it, and then he's in regret, and then he's looking for a fatwa to help sort of delete this event, to make as if this event didn't happen and this talaq and a statement of divorce didn't stem from him. Apply the same rationale here or the same understanding towards a parent when they get upset with the child and the child not listening to the parent, and then turbulence ensues between the tier of the parents and the tier of the children within the family, siblings as well. Right? Mountains out of molehills. We see blood, brothers and sisters fighting because of inheritance matters. Before inheritance matters, because father or mother did this to one child and didn't do it to another child, and allowing shaitan to fuel the concept of hatred within us and make us feel as if our parents were not fair to us and they favored another child when that wasn't the case. And the story of Yusuf alayhi salam and his brothers, this story isn't far away from us, brothers and sisters in Islam. So the concept of the Jamarat and how it can assist the family unit, brothers and sisters in Islam, is in this idea that we recognize shaitan for who shaitan is. And we take him as an enemy, as Allah told us to. Allah says, Inna shaitana lakum aduun, fattakhidhuhu aduwa. Shaitan to you is an enemy. So you are commanded to take shaitan as an enemy. Take him as an enemy. And recognize his whispers. Recognize his plots in your speech, in your actions, in how you think and how you feel. And ask yourself before you speak, especially during a conflict in the home, am I speaking to defend me, support myself, or am I speaking to raise the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is my anger here for the sake of Allah? Is me being upset here for the sake of Allah? Or is it for the sake of myself? Because if you are angry for the sake of Allah, naturally there's boundaries that govern your anger and you being upset and the actions that stem from you and the words that emanate from you and so on and so forth, right? So we need to bring this idea into the household and take this inspiration from the reality of the Hajj, that so many times, subhanAllah, shaitan is a means of breaking this bond, the bond that Allah placed between a husband and a wife and the parents and the children. And by the way, brothers and sisters in Islam, shaitan is the happiest and extremely proud. In fact, he is proud of the shayateen when they succeed in breaking up a Muslim family home. So let us take heed, brothers and sisters in Islam, and ponder over the Hajj during the days of Hajj. Let us ponder over the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam and the family of Hajj and the days of Hajj, and draw parallels and understand what we need to do to ensure that we come out of the days of the Hajj as a stronger family, as individuals, and as a unit altogether. I love you all for the sake of Allah. And until next time, Salamullahi alaykum wa rahmatuhu wa barakatuh.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd.